One by one, the DC-3s, C-47s, and C-53s rumbled off, the beginning of a long set of flights across the Atlantic to England. For some of these aircraft, it will be a homecoming. 75 years ago, they were in England, preparing for the greatest invasion in history. And 75 years ago, Lieutenant Colonel David Hamilton was about to fly into the teeth of the German war monster.
We were at the tip of the spear. Yeah.
Hamilton was a Pathfinder pilot, flying a C-47 with 18 paratroopers behind him. Their mission? Penetrate the enemy lines and mark the drop zones for the 13,000 paratroops that would follow behind them on D-Day.
When we left England, we went over the channel at minimum altitude to get below German radar, and we flew at 50 feet above the water. Pulled up when we hit the German coast and made our turn in. And as we were climbing up, we discovered that there was a cloud bank over the area of our drop zones. But we couldn't break radio silence, unfortunately. If we had, that whole drop in Normandy would have been much bit different.
Hamilton was about to rejoin his group when...
And my navigator said, "Don't move, you're perfect." So we dropped at about 35 to 40 seconds different than the flight commander in the left wing plane, and we found out later that we were within 99% perfect, all three of us, in drop zone T for tear, and that was just to the west of St. Mary Glees. And in pulling out, I dropped, once we got the shroud lines in and everything, I dropped on the deck and went out. My co-pilot said, "You better lift your right wing or you're going to take the steeple off at the church in St. Mary Glees."
The navigator set a direct course back to England.
Then we pulled up and my navigator said, "Skipper, come back here a minute." So I came back and I looked at his FBI scope, and you could look like you could walk from England to the coast of France. All the dots on the radar from boats. Unbelievable. And I said, "Wow." You started to get what the immensity of what we were involved in. So I said to my co-pilot, I said, "Stan, you go back and take a look at this." We discussed it later and he said, that was our first realization of what an unbelievably large operation it was.
Hamilton was home having breakfast when That's All Brother led the main force of C-47s to Normandy.
There were a lot of C-47s went across D-Day. I think the figure was close to 445 C-47s led by That's All Brother. And we only had 20 airplanes go in ahead of them in the Pathfinders. But we did our job and they did their job.
He received 4 air medals for doing his job, the Order of William from Holland and the French Legion of Honor.
And I'm going to wear that medal with pride over there in France.
Lieutenant Colonel David Hamilton will be in Normandy for the D-Day commemoration. He's the last surviving Pathfinder. Warren Morningstar, AOPA Live.